He wants to introduce everybody because he's the DJ. You know?
Yes, I'm the DJ.
Well, this is a man that I work with a lot on the road. He's known as the third J, J number three, from Jay and the Americans. Please welcome my good friend from Chicago area, Mr. Jay Ronke.
Jay Ronke, I will tell you this. I was following the meteors. I happened to be at the club. I don't remember exactly what club it was.
Yeah, it was some little bar.
It was in Des Plaines.
Yeah.
This band used to be Johnny Starr and the Meteors. This is Johnny Starr.
Not anymore.
So Jay and the Americans flew in to check this guy out and sat at the table with me, and I watched them, listened to him, harmonize with him at the table that show. And they looked at me and they said, he's fucking in. That's our guy. Excuse my swear, but that's why you're there. Ladies and gentlemen, the Meteors with Jay number three.
I'll tell you what, yeah, it's like a homecoming. All right, here's one of our old favorites. I don't get to do this often. I hate to say it, but I told you so. Don't mind for preaching to you. I said don't trust him, baby, now you know. You don't learn everything there is to know at school. Wouldn't believe me when I gave advice. I said that he was a tease. If you won't help, you better rest me nice. So please, if you can fix me with a pretty please. You how it feels to be lonely, oh so lonely. Don't think I'm being funny when I say you got just what you deserve. I can't help feeling you found out too late. Thought you would, you could, you had a lot of nerve. Won't say I'm sorry for the things I said. Glad he picked up to go. You kept the bragging, he was yours instead. But you don't know everything that is to know. Blah, 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 blah. It seems so funny to me. Blah, blah, you met a guy who taught you how it feels to be. Before I go, I'd like to say one thing. Don't close your ears to me. Take my advice and you'll find out that me, just another girl will cause you misery. Who's that you can't get anymore to call? Don't be so smug or else. You'll find you can't get any boy at all. You'll find a man or lady sitting on the shelf. Laugh, laugh, I'm gonna die. It seems so funny to me. Laugh, laugh, you better die. We taught you how it feels to be lonely, oh so lonely. Yeah.
Lonely, oh so lonely.
That was fun. You know, it's funny, I feel like a proud papa. These are all my old guys. Makes me feel great. Oh, who are you calling you? Tony back on the drums there. Ron over on the keyboard. We go way back. Joe Garcia, good friend of mine. Greg Favada, New Colony 6, and one heck of a guitar player. And Kenny, superior bass player. Great bunch of guys, and I always love the chance to sit in and say hi and see what they're up to. But now, I flew in this morning from Wheeling, West Virginia. We had a show last night, and as you all
or many of you know, I work with three of the original Americans. And I'll tell you what, it's been the biggest thrill of my life. But you know, it's interesting because we're here today to talk about Dick Biondi. And Sandy from the Americans told me last night that back in the early 1960s, when Jay and the Americans were really getting going, they came to Chicago and did some summer stock up in Highland Park. And one of the biggest promoters that helped them back then was Dick Biondi. So, you know, the guys in Americans all said to please acknowledge Dick today. And as for me, I just grew up listening to him. It was amazing, but now I get to be a part of a great group, a wonderful group, and we're gonna do one of their big hits for you right now. I get to do it every night, whether I like it or not, but see if you remember this one.
In a little cafe, just the other side of the border, she was sitting there and giving me looks that made my mouth water. So I started walking her way. She belonged to Ben and Jose. And I knew, yes I knew, I should leave. Then I heard her say, come a little bit closer, your life's got a mat so big and so strong. Come a little bit closer, I'm all alone, and the night is so long.
So we started to dance in my arms.
John Reinke or the third Jay and the Americans. You rock it. Let's hear it for Jay. Come on.
All right, Scott.
Thank you very much. All right. So we are getting ready to show you the trailer for the Dick Biondi film. It is the reason we are here. Ouch, that was me. Before we do that, though, I need my readers, because I'm getting old. I want to say hi to Kent Cotell from ForgottenHits.com. Where is Kent? Where are you at? The reason I also want to say hi, because he was giving away tickets, and I asked for a pair. He gave me a pair, and then my wife booked me out of town, so I had to give them back. Also, I want to say hi to Al and Delores Weissman. They have the In a Nutshell TV show. They are actually videotaping this now, and they're going to be broadcasting this on this show, and they're awesome people. What station are you on? What, Q2? U2? That's a station, U2? It's right next to the U. Oh, that U, CIU2. So U2, got it. And I get a business card. Oh, the U2, now I know what you're talking about. I thought Bono broadcast your shows in Ireland or something, my bad. Also, I want to say hi to a great comedian. If you ever do go see the shows that Dennis Stefano does as Bobby Darin with the full orchestra, Tim Walco, where is Tim Walco? I know, I just saw him. He just said hi. Oh, he's at the bar. That's where a comedian belongs. Tim Walco just came out with a brand new comedy album. He was last night in my neighborhood in St. Charles, but I had my river prom. I was up till midnight, 1:30 last night, hosting a prom for adults, which we do every year with our radio station. We had over 300 people. It was a blast. I also want to say hi to Bart Shore. He is a legend. I mean, so many people have gotten to work the proper way because of Bart Shore. He's in the doorway to my left, your right, waving. Scott Childers, he is a rock and roll legend, and he's probably worked, there he is. Scott Childers is right over here. He is an amazing man, and I mean, he goes back to the heyday of rock and roll, and to be honest with you, there is no better human being than Scott Childers. I love you. We have been with the same company for quite a while. Past tense, I'm so sorry. Okay, while we're setting up and tearing down, oh wait, I have something over here. Hi. $500, thank you very much. That's for my underwear, $500, anyone at six. First day I wore them, they're brand new. I do want to thank Mayor Roger Clare. I would never read anything. I know who he is. Mayor Clare is right here today. He's been a very big sponsor, and his beautiful wife is here as well. Bolingbrook Mayor, he always goes out of his way to make sure that people that need money, charitable organizations, and especially this one, I want this so badly. We need to go to some corporate people and get them to donate as well, because I want this film out there while Dick Biondi is still alive. And we are all here to help. Can you imagine his face if he saw this come out, this documentary, in his time? So we need to get this done. Also, I want to thank Vince Cerrone. Vince is with VC Plumbing. I know his table's over here. Vince, you have been nothing but magic for these people, and we thank you so much. So if you guys need plumbing, and guess what? We all do at one time or another. Don't wait till it's stopped up next time. Call VC Plumbing. Vince is here. And also Bill Wojcik. Is he here? Is Bill here? Bill has been an attorney in Oak Lawn for 40 plus years, and he's been helping out this organization as well. So now I want to bring up Pamela Eitzweller, police director of this Dick Biondi documentary, and her co-producer Stephanie Cerna. If you would both come up on stage. We are about to show you the trailer, but these fine young ladies need to give you some words. Hi, Ben.
Hello? I just want to say something really quick. This woman has put her life on hold for 5 years now, invested every single penny she has, and truly loves Dick Biondi. She grew up with him from the time she was 14 years old. That's what I call passion. And this movie is going to be made. Okay, everybody in this room loves Dick Biondi, and that's why you're here. And I thank you from the bottom of my heart. This wouldn't be happening without you guys. And my dear co-producer, Stephanie, she's been there from the beginning. Alan Dolores Weissman. There's so many people in this room that have been with me. Joe Farina. Oh my gosh, Joe Farina single-handedly got all these silent auction books. It was amazing. Everybody is just I can't even tell you the love in this room. It's amazing. So we're going to show you our 2-minute trailer. We don't want to take up too much time because this is a heck of a good time, right? I mean, thank you to all these incredible talented bands and artists that are here today. Honest to God, I'm really touched. So thank you. We're going to let that film roll now. And thanks and enjoy yourself.
This is the guy where all this rock and roll was born, in the CFL days and the WLS AM days. He's been in the business a long time, and he's proud to say he's been fired 25 times. A Chicago legend, put your hands together for the one and only, Dick Biondi!
This is what I play, Dick Biondi. Proud as a red violet and blue, I don't read a commercial, the boss says I'm through.
Hey, who's that? Is he on something?
He gave us an early rebel.
How many guys do you know that have been fired 25 times from any job?
He puts all the pizzas in the mail.
Use it for everybody. Elvis, the Beatles.
Dick Biondi was the first guy to play a Beatle in America.
He was in the recording studio and the Stones did Satisfaction.
He would break all records.
Back in the 60s, maybe 1,000 kids waiting to meet Dick Biondi.
He's amazing. Amazing that he's still on there, still doing what he's doing.
Let's have 3 hours of rocking and rolling.
Dick Biondi, the American rock and roll disc jockey.
Hi, everybody. I'm Dick Biondi. I'm sure you guys are having a lot of fun.
In the early 60s, like most teens, I had my radio glued to my ear, listening to rock and roll, teen blues, and my favorite disc jockey, Dick Biondi. Dick was more than a DJ. He was our friend. I've always wanted to tell Dick's story and the impact he had on the music and the people of my generation. Because for me, and for millions of baby boomers growing up in the 50s, 60s, and 70s, Dick Biondi was the voice in our cars, the voice under our pillows, and the voice that rocked America.
Oh, let's hear it for the trailer. Awesome. So it's funny, I watched the trailer that was posted, and it wasn't that same trailer, and Pam said, you're at the beginning of the trailer. I said, no, I'm not. And she goes, yes, you are. And I said, no, I'm not. I watched the trailer a couple of times, a couple of weeks ago. I said, I'm not on the trailer. And she goes, no, you are. And my wife showed it to me this morning, right before I came out here. She goes, yes, you are. You're an idiot. I said, okay, here we go again. Hey folks, if you haven't gotten your raffle tickets, if you haven't done the silent auction, that's all gonna be closing in the next few minutes. I will give you some announcements, but we're running out of time for that. We're gonna start closing things down and selling this stuff to you. So please make sure that you go and look at your auction items. And if you haven't bought raffle tickets, put them in the bags of the things that you want. I think there's like 200 things out of there. By the way, can we hear it for 115 Bourbon Street and all the people working today? Make sure you tip them well too, because they're here on a Sunday and helping us raise money for Dick Biondi. By the way, when I was at the True Oldies channel, I honestly loved the fact that I got to work with a legend. I grew up on the East Coast. So in my early days, I was listening to Sandy Beach on WKBW and a lot of the radio stations in New York. But I always knew about Dick Biondi because when it comes to radio, we know everybody down the line. And Dick was the man that really made Chicago radio great. He was one of a kind. A lot of you are going to end up in the Dick Biondi film because we're still filming and adding to that film. So people here tonight, if you stick around when we do the pizzas, the spaghetti song, you're all going to be in the documentary. So stay here for that. And if you haven't signed your life away and given the filmmakers your first child, you're gonna need to be in that film. So you guys all ready? Nope, not quite ready yet. The pizza song, I'm sorry. On top of the pizza, right? Yeah. I told you I was from the East Coast. I didn't hear the original song. Do we want to do those last two auction items while these guys get ready, or? It's fine by me. Yeah, bring those up. There's two items left. So, these are Find Your Happiness in Mexico. So these were donated. And what this is certificate entitles you to luxury accommodations at a destination for 7 nights and ground transportation from the airport to the resort. Certificate holder will pay the usage fee for the size of the unit reserved, but it is a great accommodation. It's a 5-star accommodation, the Vida Ambassador, and we have two of them. What? Mexico. It says the stunning Mexican coast, the world of Vidanta, 7 luxurious and exclusive resort destinations. So you have your choice of 7 different destinations. And again, it is 7 days. Obviously, the airline is not included, but heck, 7 nights in Mexico, bidding at an auction to save Dick Biondi's film and get it going. Who'll start the bidding at $200? And I have two of them. $200, where are you? We got 200 there, thank you very much. Anyone at 3? I'll sell 2 of these. We're at $200, anyone to give me $300? 7 nights in Mexico, 5-star resort. You just pay for your plane. These are $2,400 tickets here. The room is worth $2,400. We have 1 at $200. Anyone give me 3? Anyone at $300? I'm gonna sell these fast because I want to get back to the music. $300 here. Anyone at 4? $300 back. I got them. $300, anyone at 4? We have $300 there, anyone at 400? $300 here, it's a $2,400 vacation. $300 looking for 4? 400 where? 4 there, thank you very much. Anyone at 4? We got 4 here. I'll sell them both for 4 if you'll take it at 4. Will you take 1 at 4? 1 at 4? Have fun on your vacation. So, because I want to hear some more music. Yeah. All right, when you hear the word vintage, and after you hear these guys, you definitely are going to know what we're talking about. They are a 70s rock and roll band, and it is vintage rock and roll, Southside Exiles. We'll be right back.
Thank you. We are the Southside Exile. This is for Delores. Girls, shout out to the cats.
Turn on the wipers, roll down the windows. Baby, let your tears run dry. Turn on the wipers. Southside Exiles. Please help us out. Follow us. We need all the help we can.
Good, but now it's running. You gotta know where to move out.
For that well goes dry. I don't know why people say money can't buy happiness.
Guys, that was awesome.
That worked out good. I got mine, you got yours?
All right. Before we move on, I know that we have a lot of silent auction items that have not gotten the best of bids. This is to raise money for this film to be finished, so go check the silent auction items. We're still selling raffle tickets for a few more minutes. Got the gentleman in back, he's got the tickets up in the air. So let's get those sold, raise a little bit of more money before we shut things down here. As a matter of fact, Dennis and Carolyn Turbin are here. They're sitting right over here. I've known them for a long time. They're big fans of all the oldies, and they have actually donated. So they are kind of redesigning their house, rebuilding, and they're gonna end up moving. So they have a 1959 kitchen diner that is one of the silent auction items, a full blown, and I mean, this is awesome. There's pictures there. A 1959 diner and a 1963 mid-modern living room that is on the silent auction item. They actually have a house full of stuff that is worth quite a bit of money, and they have donated a lot of it. And I know moving forward, if we do another event, they have a lot of great, great items that are awesome. So go check that at the silent auction, buy your raffle tickets, put them in the bags. We're gonna be closing down the silent auction in 20 minutes. At 5:20, they're gonna shut it down. So make sure you check those. I also wanna thank Pete from DJ Enterprises. I may be using him in just a second to throw down something. But I did want to let you know that Jimmy Sons from Shadows of Night wanted to be here tonight, but couldn't be. He had gigs in Costa Rica. But he chose, if I can get your attention on the screens, to be here from afar.
Hi, I'm here because I'm not there, or whatever. I am away on assignment in Costa Rica, but I want to take this opportunity to talk to my dear friend, Nick Biondi. As he always asks me every day that he's seen me for the last 20 years, how you feeling, Jimmy? Well, Dick, how you feeling? I hope you're good. I hope everything's fine by you and the missus. I have had a great, wonderful opportunity in my lifetime to work with Dick Biondi, to work and know Dick Clark, to work and know Wolfman Jack. And I can tell you that they are three of the greatest people that were ever in as part of show business. The Dick Biondi film is happening, and we're here to make sure funds are raised so that will happen. I want to say hi to Carl, Jim Ricci, to guys and marks from all the New Colony Six, all the Chicago Rockers, the Cornerstones of Rock, who without Dick Biondi and people like him, none of us would have a career. Well, maybe Jim and Peter would still live in a house that Sloan built. But I live in a house that Kathy built. While I'm at it, Dick Biondi, this is for you. Because I was just elected into the Hall of Fame, and it would not have happened without Little Steven, without all the people out there. So I want to thank everybody for that, especially you, Dick, because I couldn't have done it without you. I wish I could be there, Dick, I really do, but I'm stuck in 90 degree weather down in Costa Rica with the Rock Pack, Boston, Toto, Shadows, Santana. It'll be a fun show, and I know that I'm missing a fun show back there. Everybody, let's get it on for Nick.
Ladies and gentlemen, Jimmy Sons, Shadows of Night. That's awesome. That's a good tribute to a great man. It is so sad that he couldn't be here. He looks good though. Because, I mean, he wasn't doing so well about a year ago, and look at how he's recovered, so that's awesome. And Bob Surratt had said to us that Dick should be on the mend as well, and hopefully we will see him soon as well. But we are here to raise money for that film. In the meantime, we're going to be, once again, silent auction. Raise your hand if you want any raffle tickets. Gentlemen right here selling them. You can put them in the bags that you want. We're going to draw those in the next 15 or 20 minutes. Because we have our headliner coming up. But until that time happens, we're getting ready for our headliner. We're gonna turn things to Pete, DJ Enterprises. Give me something on the screen, on the audio.
I wanna play a song that was recorded right here in Chicago at 2120 South Michigan Avenue, which is now a historic landmark, by a guy excited today. It's one of the cornerstones of rock and roll. He was recording before Elvis and before all the rest of it. And he's still around, and he's still doing the best duck walk anybody can do. Ladies and gentlemen, let's find out about Louisiana from Mr. Chuck Berry and